In this very moment, I slay Goliath with a sling. This very moment, I bring quest or everything. That I will retire with the ring, and I will retire with the crown. Yes, no, I'm not lucky, I'm blessed. Yes, clap for the heavyweight champ, me. But I couldn't do it all alone. We, young money raised me, grew up out in Baisley, Southside Jamaica, Queens, and it's crazy. Cause I'm still hood, Hollywood couldn't change me. Shout out to my haters, sorry that you couldn't faze me. Ain't being cocky, we just vindicated. Best believe that when we done, this moment will be syndicated. I don't know. This mic just remind me of everything they deprived me of. Put your drinks up. It's a celebration every time we link up. We done did everything they could think of. Greatness is what we wanna bring up.
That I can have this moment for life.
All right, so let's talk about sacrifice. To get started, I'll give you my personal definition of what sacrifice is. Sacrifice is voluntarily giving up something that is of value to you to effect a change. Again, it's voluntarily giving up something that is of value to you to effect a change. And what we're going to do for this month, we're actually going to break that definition down because there are three major components that I want to discuss. But before we do that, I'll give you a little background on where I came with this topic from. You know, we're a couple weeks into the Lent season, and Christians all over the world are celebrating and so forth in preparation for Resurrection Sunday, going through a 40-day journey or 40 days of fasting. And as I talk to people, when we talk about the fast, you know, and things they're giving up, whether it's food, whether it's material items or social media and so forth, you know, I began to discover not only the importance of fasting, as I've known for years, but how important it is for us on a daily basis, and even more so than during the annual, you know, fast, if you will. And the reason being is the underlying principle behind fasting is sacrifice. And that's the one thing that I hope that people are understanding as they're turning away from whatever it is they're turning away from, that they're learning to sacrifice and to get closer to God and to where they want to be. So let's talk about the three components in that definition. Again, the definition is voluntarily giving up something that is of value to you to effect a change. So the first thing is it has to be voluntary. You have to have a desire to give up these things. Now, if you're doing it begrudgingly, or you're just doing it because someone else is doing it, or you think it's what you should do, then you won't see the difference. You won't affect that change that you want. You won't get to a new level because it's not of a pure or even a clear intention. It's just going through the motion. And as we talked about before, whenever you're going through the motion, you won't reap what you should reap out of it because you're not giving it your all. So it has to be something that you are voluntarily giving up. Something that you're saying, you know what, I want to sacrifice. I want to give this up, even though this means something to me. I'm deciding to give this up. The second part of the definition is something that is of value to you. Again, if you're just giving up something that you don't see value in, or you could take or leave it, then you won't get anything from it. You won't have that next level blessing that you desire. And that's all across the board. That's not only when you talk about a fast, that's in general. Sacrifice in general is predicated upon it has to be something that is of value to you. Otherwise, there's no sacrifice. And if you look at sacrifice through the years, people have sacrificed their life for others, for a cause. You know, people have given things that has been valuable to them so someone else can benefit. And then that third and that final part is to effect a change. And anytime we talked about effecting a change, we're talking about reaching a goal, being different than we were before. So let's take a look at the fast. If after this 40-day journey, you're at the same place you were on day one, then what have you gained? Absolutely nothing. You've gained nothing. You've benefited nothing because there's no change. You should be better on the end than you were in the beginning. And here's the reason why I say that. Because if you really are giving up something, you're really sacrificing something that's valuable to you and you're doing it voluntarily, then when the time is over, you will be at a different level, whether it's a growth in your ministry, in your personal life, in your relationships, you know, with the people around you at work and your business dealings and whatever avenues or whatever areas that you want to see growth in. If you're not giving up, if you're not sacrificing things, then you won't reap the benefits. Let's be real. Sacrificing is not easy. It can be very difficult and very challenging. But it's very important. I read somewhere that every successful person along their journey, along their road to success, had to sacrifice something or some things. Keep in mind, along your journey, along your road, as you travel, if you want to be successful, if you want to be great, then there are some things that you will have to sacrifice. But always remember, when you get to the other side and when you look back, you'll recognize that the things that you voluntarily gave up that were of value to you to effect a change was worth it all along. God bless.